Hello and welcome back to Open, everyone. You know, we're always inviting you to get social with us. That's right. Tweet us at BronxNet TV. And while you're there, tweet me too at Rena Valentin. On Sunday, April 2nd, the Minority Women Professionals Conference will bring together women across the tri-state area. The conference is designed to inspire and empower minority women from diverse backgrounds while providing them with the tools necessary for success in the field of medicine. Joining us now to share more, please welcome the CEO and founder of Inspire Health Solutions, Wanda Ola Ewola.
Yes.
I did it right. Yeah,
Ola Ewola. Yes, good job. Ola Ewola. Good job.
Thank you for working with me.
Thank you
for having goodness.
Me.
Thank you for being here with us. I know there's a short term for a short name for you, right? It's Dr.
Wando.
Okay, that's what we're going with
Wando.
For the rest of the segment. Dr. Wando. All right. Dr. Wando. So how challenging has that been throughout your entire career?
Yeah, well, it's been a challenge, but I mean, people do all kinds of things, Dr. O, Dr. Wando, but I've landed on Dr. Wando. I feel like that gets what I want. So yeah, I like that.
Okay, I like it too.
I'm happy for you to use it.
I like it too, and I like that you're not offended. Forgive me, I tried.
No worries.
How many syllables was that? Like six?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about yourself, how you got to where you are. I mean, you're a highly decorated doctor.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, a graduate of Harvard. I mean, let's just you share with our viewers everything that you've accomplished. It's really, really impressive.
Thank you. Well, thanks again for having me. So I am a family doctor. I'm the child of Nigerian immigrants and grew up kind of all over in the Midwest. And I went to medical school with a passion to be able to take care of people, but also communities. And right now, my current job, I work as a physician. It's called the Chief Clinical Transformation Officer for a health technology company, and also on faculty at University of California, San Francisco. But throughout my career, I've been dedicated to improving kind of the experience of minorities and helping them get to their next step. And so that's why I'm here now doing this work around minority women professionals.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you for making a difference. And also, in reading a little bit about Inspired Health Solutions, mm-hmm. It kind of presents itself to be kind of like a mosh posh of like traditional medical care combined with holistic care. Can you share a little bit more about what inspired this whole concept for you?
Yeah, so Inspire Health Solutions is a combination of just helping improve the way we deliver care, but also making sure that that our own care is not overlooked. And so a lot of times people that are providing care, so me as a doctor, we forget to take care of ourselves and we take so much care of the people around us and the patients that we have and forget to take care of ourselves. So it's both a combination of being sure that you're giving good care outside, but also taking good care of yourself.
That's wonderful. So it's like this medical community
in
which you're reminded to, well, how are you going to care for someone if you're not caring for yourself, right?
For yourself, exactly.
So just share a little bit about like what's offered within Inspired Solutions.
So it's like personal coaching and professional coaching. So helping people in whatever their kind of career is in healthcare, helping them grow to achieve what their next step might be, providing skills and mentoring, but also life coaching. Like, how do you go through difficult decisions? How do you negotiate for certain parts of what you're looking for, and then how do you actually build in wellness and self-care into your daily routine?
So it's kind of like almost having your own like coach,
like
right?
It's like
having your own life coach, but specifically for a field, right?
Yeah.
And so from just based on what you shared, you offer like the business aspect, the wellness aspect for self. Personally, I feel that within society, mental health, I don't know what's, I'm a little under the weather,
that's
so
right.
Forgive me.
That's okay.
I'm like, thank that's God okay. There's a doctor in the house.
I got you.
Oh my gosh, I love it. And so Dr. Wando, okay, just so you guys are, and so, I just within our nation, mm-hmm. It's great that what you're offering to the actual medical professionals, because the health wellness is, for me, is overlooked.
Yeah. I mean, if you're going to see a doctor, you want them to be taking care of themselves, right? Like, we know that doctors in the United States burn out and have symptoms of burnout and cynicism and higher rates of thinking about suicide than most other professions. So we have to start taking care of ourselves.
Right. And so you have this amazing conference that's coming up that is for women of color who are in the field.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about that.
This conference series, it's a national conference series. It's called Minority Women Professionals Are MVPs, like, you know, MVPs, you know, winners. Mm-hmm. And the whole goal is to go across the United States and just have these one-day experiences where people will learn, be empowered and inspired in their professions, but also get skills, actual practical skills that they can use to survive, what we say is survive and thrive. And it's we're doing this because we know that minority women women in general face a lot of challenges in professional workspaces, but women of color, women with disability, women of non-dominant religions, of LGBTQ status, they face additional stresses and hurdles. And so trying to give them tools to be able to be successful is what we're doing.
Do you find that more women are taking on the medical field?
There
aren't enough for you, as far as you're concerned.
Yeah. I mean, because, you know, what happens is if you're thinking about it, you know, maybe you're in high school or in college, you're thinking about it, but you don't see a lot of women, and you don't see women that look like you, don't see women of color, you don't feel like that's a place that you can go. So if we can start to bring the people together, give the visual so that the younger women can see that this is a possibility, this is a potential pathway for me, then hopefully we'll get more into the fields.
So this conference is actually beneficial to college students who are considering the field as well.
Absolutely. In fact, we've been very deliberate about having these conferences in college campuses or in learning environments, I should say. So Albert Einstein College of Medicine is hosting this one here in the Bronx, and, you know, really excited because they're sharing this with not only the medical students, but the students that are also kind of that feed into the school so that they can see these wonderful, incredible women that we have lined up to be here.
So just before we go, just tell us who's going to be a part of it. And also take us just through one day within the conference of what one would experience.
Sure. Okay. So, you know, the day is, it's 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. So it's on Sunday, April 2nd. We have a mixture of inspirational, motivational talks by some really, really powerful, compelling women who've gone through incredible obstacles to get where they are. We also have breakout sessions. Some of the breakouts will focus on wellness. So we have a wonderful woman named Palin who's coming to do this. She does Afro yoga and building in kind of yoga into your life. We have another organization called Hair on Purpose, which goes around and does workshops for women, helping them feel empowered through their hair. We have speakers, a woman coming from Paris, our keynote speaker, Rakaya Diallo, who's an activist and filmmaker, who will be sharing things there as well. And then my sister, my younger sister, who's an attorney in New Jersey, is going to be coming sharing some skills around kind of building your own self and building your own practice. So, and many, many more.
Wow. So one's a doctor, the other one's an attorney. Boy, you ladies were determined.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. You're a great example.
Oh, thank you.
And thank you for coming here and sharing it with us. And thank you for facilitating this here in the Bronx.
Thank you. Yo, I'm glad to do it in the Bronx.
And so if anybody wanted to participate, how would they go about doing
so? Yes, they can go to inspirehealthllc.com, inspirehealthllc.com. And that there's more information about the conference, how to register. And they can connect with us as well at IHS LLC on Twitter and Instagram.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you, Dr.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much
Wonderful.
For having me.
Wonderful. Yes. And once again, you guys, the Minority Women Professionals Conference is taking place on Sunday, April 2nd from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Albert Einstein College of Medicine located on 1301 Morris Park Avenue in the Bronx. And for more information, visit inspirehealthllc.com. All right, we're taking a quick break, but we'll be back with more Open when we return.